We're offloading a little over 39,000 pounds of cocaine, and this is cocaine interdicted at sea and in its purest form. 2016 at 416,600 pounds is the Coast Guard's largest seizure record ever.
San Diego Port Control.
We've been underway about 80 days since we left home port. The primary mission for this last deployment was counter drug. Quite often that's occurring far from home. There's a significant amount of cocaine that is in Central America and South America ready to come to the U.S. Our increased numbers are a sign of increased flow. It's much easier to find it when it's coming from a source country than it is before it arrives in the U.S. In the Eastern Pacific, the predominant method of transport for these drug trafficking organizations is what we call a panga, which is typically a 35 or 30 foot open boat made of wood and fiberglass. They're very small, very hard to see, and the materials they're made of make it very hard to detect on radar. The self-propelled semi-submersible is another form of drug trafficking vessel. Seems to be seeing them more frequently. You can imagine a submarine that basically sits right at the top of the water. All you really can see of the vessel is a little conning tower, big enough for one person to sit in, look out a window, and steer. It's very, very difficult to find and can carry a significant amount of contraband, up to 15,000 pounds. We interdicted a self-propelled semi-submersible vessel on this last deployment. So when we found it, we snuck up on it and were able to covertly get alongside and board the decks. The whole time, though, it was pretty risky because those vessels do get quite unstable, and the drug trafficking organizations rather have them sink than get caught. We partner with other nations to try and to stop this flow that not only hurts the U.S., but hurts these countries in the transit zone as well.